So, picture with me, it's 1974, New York City, and I am in love with two buildings, two towers, or as everyone in the world calls them, the Twin Towers of the World Trade Center. They call to me, these towers, they stir something inside of me, and they inspire in me a dream. My dream is to hang a high wire between those Twin Towers and walk on it. Of course, this is impossible, not to mention illegal. So, why attempt the impossible? Why follow your dream? But I cannot answer this question why, not with words, but I can show you how it happened. Suddenly, I freeze. The pain in my tooth is gone. In the magazine, there's an article with an illustration about the towers. They're not even finished yet, but the magazine says that once they are, they will be the tallest in the world. Et voilà. My dream.
And this is you?
Yes. It will be the most glorious high wire walk in history.
And how high must this wire be to make so much glory?
Over 100 stories high.
Where do trees like this grow?
These are not trees. Now, walking on the wire is as much mental as it is physical. If you lose your concentration, you lose your balance.
Philippe!
So here I am, in the mud, to my knees, doing the Papa Rudy compliment. I was walking along the Seine, feeling sorry for myself, when I look up and I saw the towers of Notre Dame. And I said, this is where I must put my wire. This is how I will redeem myself. So Jean-Louis and I stay up all night installing a wire between these two ancient towers. And when the first tourists start to arrive in the morning, I begin.
Look.
This is a sign. In the same newspaper as my Notre Dame story, this is Providence.
Mm-hmm. It says they're almost finished. The lower floors are already occupied.
Annie, we need to pack.
They're enormous.
This. They're monstrous. Of course, I automatically look across to the opposite tower, but then I have to dare to look down. Now. I think I know the void. I'm a wire walker. The void is my domain, yes? Well, not this void. But still, I gather the courage to whisper. I whisper so the demons won't hear me. It's impossible. But I'll do it. All I could see was the wire floating out in a straight line to infinity. And if I were to shift my weight, I would become a wire walker. By now, I'm becoming aware of the people on the ground below watching me, my audience. And even though this is something a wire walker should never do, I look down. Peaceful, just calm and serene, not dangerous.
My name is Philippe Petit. I'm a wire walker.
Show's over. Now, come on.
Why are you attempting something so dangerous?
There is no why, just because. When I see a beautiful place to put my wire, I cannot resist.
Later in the day, a judge sentenced Petit to walk the wire again, but this time in Central Park, where a crowd of children and only a few feet off the ground.
Look at that. I mean, we did it. Philippe, we showed the world that anything's possible.
They're different. Hey, Philippe, they're different now.
Yeah, that's right. They're different because you walked up there. You know every New Yorker I talk to now says they love these towers?
Perhaps you brought them to life, given them a soul.
Because it was a beautiful day. And you know this pass I was given? Well, these passes, they have a date on them. A date when they expire. But on my pass, Mr. Tozzoli, he crossed out the date. And he wrote on it, forever.
Search the whole building.
took us the better part of the whole evening.
It did a double take, and he noticed right on the ground of World Trade Center 6, there was a structure that looked like a Christian cross.
And I directed the firefighter that was assisting me to take a look into the pit. In the middle stood the cross. It brought such overwhelming feelings to me that it dropped me to my knees in tears.